These are my absolute favorite tips for tweaking brushes. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going over the top brush tweaks that you can do to your Procreate brushes, demystifying the Procreate Brush Studio, and those are the things that we're doing. So let's get into it.
The truth shall set you free.
Before we dive in, first of all, you should, as a best practice, always back up your brushes. Whether you're editing them or not, backing up your brushes, your color palettes, and your artwork is a really good idea. So make sure that you have a hard copy of everything saved, where if you totally lose something or tweak it and can't reset it for whatever reason, you have a copy that you can re-import. Those things being said, let's get into it. So Procreate 5 came with a new brush engine, and if you don't know what that means, that's okay. It's just better than before, and that's really all you need to know. It can be really intimidating to hop into the Brush Studio. I totally get it. There's a lot of different settings. The Procreate manual is a really great resource to kind of get in depth on anything, but don't be afraid to jump in there and do it. These are some super easy tweaks that you can do that you can always reset back to normal. To get into the Brush Studio, once you have selected a brush, you're gonna tap once more and it'll open up this whole Brush Studio. Before we even start adjusting, we're going to go into the About Brush, and here we can see this has a reset point, it is saved, all of that. But not all brushes are gonna have this. So for the purpose of this, I'm just going to create a basic brush. And then when I go into it and I go to the About This Brush section, there is no reset point. If this is the case, hit create a new reset point and save before you make any changes. And then if you ever want to go back and reset it, you just go into About This Brush and hit reset. Then you want to be sure to hit done and not cancel. Alternatively, you can swipe over and duplicate the brush. So those are the two options if your brush doesn't have saved info. Let's talk about the Brush Studio in general. Every adjustment that you make in here, you are not able to undo it a single step. If you make an adjustment in here and you just want to go, you know, back out of the brush and try again, what you can do is hit cancel and then go back in, and it won't save the adjustments that you made in that Brush Studio session, so to speak. That being said, you have to be sure to hit done to save any adjustments that you have made. So the first adjustment we're going to talk about is Streamline. Streamline can be a great beginner brush assistance kind of setting because it smooths out the line as you draw and helps give your stroke a little more guidance on the canvas as you're painting. So if I am to draw here, this is no Streamline adjustment. It is extremely responsive to any shakes, jitters, rumples along the line. If I turn up the Streamline, this is going to make it a much more smooth stroke that doesn't pick up on quite the same amount of organic squiggles, if you will. And if I turn it up all the way, it's going to be almost like a stickiness. It is kind of like magnetic to the canvas. You'll often see calligraphy brushes with a really high Streamline amount. So whether you are painting viney things, leaves and stems, or if you are doing calligraphy and hand lettering and trying to get into that, this can be a really great tool to use to your advantage. You can adjust it along a spectrum. And it can be a good way, if you aren't getting the smoothness of strokes that you want, this can be a good way to help you get there as you're learning. And also for anything that you want to have a more fluid look, maybe a little less organic, this is a good attribute to adjust for that. Next section is taper, and we are going to be focusing on pressure taper. Touch taper is if you have a third-party stylist, or if you're drawing or painting with your finger, or if you're in Procreate Pocket, that is what touch taper affects, but the Apple Pencil has pressure sensitivity and responsiveness built in and can naturally pick up on the amount of pressure on the screen to taper the brush as you're drawing. This will adjust, as you can see, the size of the taper. So it gets really sharp here, and this adjusts the pressure sensitivity. You can adjust the taper to impact both the size and the opacity of the stroke at the beginning and the end. It helps replicate that thin, thick look that you get when you're painting with a round brush. And especially in watercolor, I find that this is a good adjustment to have. It helps you create more shapes with the actual stroke of the brush a little more effortlessly. My next adjustment is the entire wet mix section. I do a lot of watercolor and I love making the paint act as real and organic as possible. And I like knowing what these things do and being able to change it based on what I'm trying to achieve. So going down the list, dilution is essentially how much water is mixed in with the paint on your brush. It impacts the opacity and translucence of what you're painting.
If you turn up your dilution and your brush does this, you can adjust the grade into the positive side and it will help render some of that.
Dilution is more impactful, more obvious when it's paired with charge and vice versa. So the charge is the amount of pigment or paint on your brush when you go to paint at the beginning of the stroke. So if you paint a long stroke and you have a low level of charge and a high level of dilution, you will run out of pigment on your page as you're painting until you lift up your brush again. And that's essentially like re-dipping your brush. My notes are over here. If I am not able to cut out all of my head turning, that's why. The next one is attack, and attack is how much paint stays on your canvas. So if you want a really bold, intense, consistent stroke, turning attack up all the way will help you achieve that. The next one in this section is pull, and this affects how your brush interacts with the pigment and paint already on the canvas, as well as the pigment and paint as you're painting it in that stroke. And so you have like a high percentage of pull. This allows the brush to behave as if it's actually moving paint around.
So I wanna show you what that can look like. So you can see it's really strong at the beginning of the stroke and then it fades out to completely transparent. But it also has maximum pull and no attack. So very little paint is sticking to the canvas and it just really looks super watery. And then if I lift up my pencil and paint again, I'm still able to blend in some of these previous strokes. Not completely, it's not like totally wet, but it does still behave. You know, it's not just getting darker and darker up here.
Finally, wetness jitter is a randomosity, a variance in how wet your brush is. Essentially, it helps it look more organic and realistic and can help achieve that feel if that's what you're going for. So this section, especially if you're playing around with watercolor stuff, this is a great spot to dive into. So next we have color dynamics, which is a super fun addition that Procreate 5 released. And there is so much that you can change, but I'm going to go through what I adjust here without touching too much on the ones that I don't. So I don't work with stamp color jitter that much. What I do play with is stroke color jitter, specifically the hue and the brightness. That allows each individual stroke to be slightly different depending on which attribute you adjust. I like adjusting hue maybe like 5% to get just a slight color variation. It helps replicate the look of real hand-mixed paint. Also for watercolor, not the only thing that I paint, but I do really enjoy it specifically for watercolor brushes. Adjusting the hue, again, just like 5% is an awesome difference. Now, stroke color jitter affects each individual stroke, but there's not color variation in like one single stroke. If you adjust color pressure and color tilt, you can get the different color effects in that single stroke. And so this is another adjustment that I like to make to get that hand mixed color feel. All right, so under the Apple Pencil section, if you don't have an Apple Pencil, this won't apply to you, but if you do, a couple things that you want to adjust here, pressure size and pressure opacity. When I talk about pressure sensitivity, this is largely the attribute that I'm referring to. It's when it is thin under light pressure, which replicates painting with a real brush. Opacity, same deal. Light would be transparent and heavy pressure is more opaque. You can play around with this. I love doing pressure sensitive brushes, and you can also really change the whole dynamic of a brush with this single attribute alone. Now under properties, what you're gonna wanna look for is the smudge bar. This impacts how the brush behaves and how much it smudges when you're using it on the smudge tool. So if you want your brush to move stuff around more with the smudge tool, increase this. And then under here we have minimum and maximum size and opacity. And you might see that you are totally maxed out in size and you wanna make your brush bigger. There's a way that we can do this. We're gonna go up into stroke path and increase the spacing of the brush just slightly, a couple percent will do it, and you can then go back into properties and increase the scale. And you can repeat as needed if you want to keep increasing the maximum size of your brush. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that this was helpful. Hopefully you learned something. Leave any questions or comments that you have below. If I didn't cover something and you want to learn about it, let me know. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Feel free to subscribe for more. I put out new videos weekly-ish. Follow me on Instagram, Snag, my newsletter. I send out new color palettes every month along with a bunch of other goodies, freebies, etc. Trying to focus on it more, make it valuable content. Give me feedback if you like it or don't like it. I would love to hear. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Guys, I'm really casual in these videos. This is my first time home alone in like 2 months because my husband's been quarantined with me and he had to go to the office for meetings today. So I am like filming all the videos today. And that's it. I need to stop filming. I'm getting punchy.